الحمد لله الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي يستحق أن يحمد في وقت الفرح وفي وقت الامتحان. الحمد لله دائم الفضل والعطاء. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبد الله ورسوله. إن شاء الله today we'll talk about الحمد لله سبحانه وتعالى. Thankfulness to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في سورة النحل: وإن تعدوا نعمة الله لا تحصوها. And if you try to count the benefit of one of Allah's blessing, you cannot. وقال تعالى: وما بكم من نعمة فمن الله سبحانه وتعالى. وما بكم من نعمة فمن الله. Any favor you have, it is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my dear sister and brother, today when I will talk about thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have to think, Allah give us everything. He give us family, He give us food, He give us health, He give us wealth, He give us even air to breathe and light to see in the morning and night to take rest, give us a shelter or a roof on top of us so we can sleep. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provide for everything. He is our creator. And in return, we shall see now all this favor of Allah, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala need in return. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في سورة النحل: والله أخرجكم من بطون أمهاتكم لا تعلمون شيئا وجعل لكم السمع والأبصار والأفئدة. I will not complete the ayah. So Allah brought you out of the womb of your mother, and then He gave you the hearing, the sight, and give you sight and hearts. And then we'll stop here. وفي سورة النحل أيضا، and سورة النحل: وهو الذي سخر البحر لتأكلوا منه لحما طريا وتستخرجوا منه حلية تلبسونها وترى الفلك مواخر فيه ولتبتغوا من فضله. فل صح. وقال تعالى في سورة القصص: Oh, we have to translate in English. It is who made the sea useful to you so that you can eat fresh flesh from it and bring out from it ornament to wear. And you see the ships passing through it so that you can seek his bounty. Again, we didn't complete the ayah. وفي سورة القصص: ومن رحمته جعل لكم الليل والنهار لتسكنوا فيه ولتبتغوا من فضله. And he make for you day and night, so in day you can work, and then in night you can rest, so you can ask for Allah bounty. So these three ayat, which is just an example, each ayah was not completed. If we go back to these three ayat, we'll find the three ayat will be end with one with word, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. Really with one sentence, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. Maybe or so that you might show thanks. So every one of the three ayat which showing Allah blessing to us is just telling us in the end of the ayah that we maybe show thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the first ayah, وَهُوَ الَّذِي أَخْرَجَكُمْ مِنْ بِطُونِ أُمَّهَاتِكُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ شَيْئًا وَجَعَلَ لَكُمِ السَّمْعَ وَالْأَبْصَارَ وَالْأَفْئِدَةَ. The rest of the ayah, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. So all these ayat, three which I just mentioned, is supposed to be ended by these two words, لَعَلَّكُمْ, maybe you will thank Allah, تَشْكُرُ. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have to be sure that always we have to remember and thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because this is very important for all of us. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَاذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ وَاشْكُرُوا لِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ. Allah said, فَاذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ وَاشْكُرُوا لِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ. Remember me, I remember you, and thank me, and don't be kafir. So listen to this story. One of the Sahaba, every time after he pray, he just right away he go home. So Rasulullah, every time after the prayer, look for this Sahabi, he can't find him. So one day after he prayed, so Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam told him, why you wait after the prayer? So he told him, Ya Rasulullah, wallahi, we have only one garment, me and my wife. So my wife wait for me until I go home, then she can pray on it. So he went home, that his wife, the Sahabi went home, his wife asked him, why you are late? She was counting by tasbihat, how many tasbiha. By the time when she finished the number, then she find her husband at home. But this night he was late. So when he came back, then she asked him, why you are late? He told her that, أوقفني رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Rasulullah talked to me after the prayer. So I told him, well, every day I don't wait after the prayer because I have to go fast to my house so my wife can use the garment and then she can do her prayer. So his wife told him, أَشَكَوْتَ رَبِّكَ لِمُحَمَّدِ Did you complain about what Allah give you to Muhammad? You see, subhanAllah, even one garment. And she was upset that even that the man talked to Sayyidina Muhammad and then she thought that he was complaining, while the Sahabi did not complain. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all min ash-shakirin ad-dhakirin, from the people always remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and thank him. Also from what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَيَرْضَ عَنِ الْعَبْدِ إِذَا أَكَلَ الْأَكْلَةِ أَنْ يَحْمَدُ وَإِذَا شَرَبَ الشَّرْبَةِ أَنْ يَحْمَدُ Allah will be pleased with the slave. When he eat, he will thank Allah, and when he take or when he drink, he thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is why a man went to a city to visit his friend. When he went to the city, then he was walking on the street, then he find or he heard really a voice saying, Alhamdulillah alladhi afani mimma abtala bihi ghayri wa faddalni ala kathiran mimman khaqa tafdila. So the man walked to this sound, and then he still heard what the man saying, Alhamdulillah alladhi afani mimma abtala bihi ghayri وَفَضَّلْنِي عَلَى كَثِيرًا مِمَّنْ خَلَقَ تَفْضِيلًا So the man thanking Allah, and then he approached him, then he found these voices coming from a man which is really blind, and then he has no limbs, no arm, no legs. So he told him, why you say what you said? Praise to Allah that he gave me what he didn't give other people and then protect me from some of the stuff which he really punish the people with. Why you say that? Why I see that you cannot walk, you cannot see, and then you don't have arm, legs. He told him, still alhamdulillah, because still Allah left to me lisanun dhakir, a tongue in which I can say the name of Allah and thank him. Wa qalbun khashi', and a heart in which, you know, is humble when I stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then wa jasadun sabir limtihan Allah, and a body in which can take the test of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it is patient. You see, he cannot see, he cannot hear, he cannot walk, And he was thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is why Aisha radiallahu anha قالت في الحديث كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يصلي حتى تنفطر قدماه فقلت له يا رسول الله لما تفعل ذلك ولقد غفر لك الله ما تقدم من ذنبك وما تأخر فقال لها رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يا عائشة ألا أكون عبدا شكورا So Aisha told the Rasulullah, she said in the hadith that Rasulullah, he stand for prayer until his feet get swollen. So one night she told him, Ya Rasulullah, why you do all of that? And Allah forgive all your sins, you are sinless. So why you do that? Then he answered, he said, Oh Aisha, I'm not supposed to be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is giving us that a very important message that thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is part of worshipping Him. Thanking Allah, it is part of worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is what Rasulullah said, that when he start and worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is really thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So another story, it was during Sayyidina Musa time. Sayyidina Musa, one day he was walking, then he find a man very rich. Have a lot of money, wealth. And the man approached Sayyidina Musa and he told him, Ya Musa, I have a lot of wealth. And can you make dua for Allah so he can decrease my wealth? Because I cannot handle it. رجل قابل موسى فقال له هو رجل غني جدا قال له يا موسى ادعو ربك حتى يقلل من ثروتي فإني لا أستطيع أن أتحكم فيها وأتعامل فيها فأكمل موسى فوجد رجل آخر فقير معدوم وجسده مغطي بالرمال حتى يدار عورته لا طعام ولا شرب ولا أي حاجة فالرجل جاء لسيدنا موسى وقال له يا موسى ادعو لك ربك ادعو لي ربك أن يرزقني ويعطيني من مال ما يكفي So this man which is very poor and only his body was covered with sand to cover his awra, he told Musa that can you ask Allah to increase my wealth? I don't have anything, no food, nothing, no clothes. So Sayyidina Musa made dua for both of them to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh Allah, decrease the wealth of the first one and give, you know, something risk for the second one. Oh Allah, Ya Rabbi, قلل من ثروة الأول وأعطي للثاني ثروة. فأوحى له ربه. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to Musa. يا موسى إذا كان الأول يريد أن أنقص من ثروته فلا يشكرني. يوقف الشكر لي. Oh Moses, if the first one want me to decrease his wealth, he's supposed to stop thanking me. So Musa went to the man and told him, Allah revealed to me, if you want to get your wealth decreased, don't thank Allah. So the man told him, how? Allah give me everything. He give me my wealth, he give me everything I have. I cannot stop thanking him. I have to thank him day and night. So Musa told him, that's the only way. So the man told him, okay, I will take good care of my wealth, but I cannot stop thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he went to the second man and he told the poor man, وقال له, إذا كنت تريد أن يغنيك الله فاشكر الله. فقال له الرجل: أشكره على ماذا؟ ليس عندي طعام ولا مشرب ولا لابس ولا حاجة خالص، لن أشكر الله. Then when he went to the second, he told him, you have to thank Allah to whatever you have, even you have the poorest one. He told him, why I thank him? I have nothing. I will not thank him. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered the wind. Allah أمر الريح. فجاءت ريح قوية أزاحت الرمال من عليه فأصبح عاريا تماما. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered the wind. The wind came and then removed even the sand which covered his awra. Then he was naked completely. So my dear brother and sisters, you have just from this story to know, any things Allah giving to you, it is a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you have to thank Allah. You have to be sure that what you do, it is only nothing compared to what Allah blessed us with. And always you have to know that. وَعَسَىٰ أَن تَكْرَهُوا شَيْئًا وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ وَعَسَىٰ أَن تُحِبُّوا شَيْئًا وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ وَعَسَىٰ أَن تُحِبُّوا شَيْئًا وَهُوَ شَرٌّ لَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Maybe you love something and it is bad for you. Maybe you dislike something and it's good for you, and Allah knows and you know not. And I will end my talk with this very small story. It was a man and he didn't have a job. So they called him, they said, oh, we have a job in such a place. You have to come tomorrow for an interview. Then he has to go tomorrow to the airport, take the airplane, and then go for his interview. So the man wake up in the morning, went to the airport early, and then, you know, he take a ride to the airport, but he's stuck in the traffic. So by the time when he reached the airport, he already, his flight was departure. Halas, he's late. He started, you know, he says, this is my luck. Why that's happened to me? Why, Ya Rabbi, that's happened to me? All this nonsense stuff which we said. Went back home. He was very upset. And then he sat in front of TV. And then he turned on. And then he heard the news that the plane which he supposed to take to go to this city for his interview was burned on air and everybody died. Then he say now, Alhamdulillah. So again, I'm reminding you, don't never be sorry to anything's happened. Anything's happened. Know that even now, what's happening to us with this corona, say Alhamdulillah. قُلْ لَنْ يُصِبَنَا إِلَّا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَنَا. All thanks to God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because nothing will happen to us except what Allah wrote for us. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.